So first of all, good morning to every one of you sitting here, online as well as offline. Syllabus, as last time I told you, is over. So this time what we are doing, it means we are due to this revision. But before starting up with the revision, I would like to say one thing about your syllabus, about your pre-board exam, which is very, very, very important for you to listen. Pre-board board exams, syllabus pattern is entirely changed. Entirely changed in the sense, undoubtedly we'll get 1 mark question, undoubtedly we'll get 5 mark question, 3 mark question we'll get. But the style of questions have got changed. You might have gone through the sample papers issued by CBSE, through NET, you might have gone through, might have seen that also. Resource-based questions are there, maybe of history, maybe of economics, maybe of geography. And undoubtedly, map work is here, 4 mark map work is here. And if you really want to score marks, you have to be very attentive about your map work. Otherwise, if you want to know about the pattern, I would say that this has become very scoring. You people can easily score marks, but if you have gone through the chapter of or the book of NCERT. I repeat, if you are going through each and every chapter of NCERT, it's very, very, very easy for you to score marks. Very easy for you to score marks. Because there is nothing to cram. In this paper, in this pattern, pre-board exams, which will be in December, the same type of pattern, the same type of question paper we have framed, and the same paper will, type of pattern would be followed, or in the board exams, you will see the same kind of pattern. It means what? You have to go through the chapters. I repeat, you have to go through the chapter. Read the chapter again, again, and again. It's not like this, you just have to go through the sample papers or exam issue, whatever books, names are the exam group and all that. Taking help from sample paper, that is entirely your wish. But being a teacher, I would suggest you to go through the chapters. Go through whatever I have taught you in the class. Go through whatever you have noted down in your book, in your notebook. Go through whatever is written in NCERT book, which is very important. If you have listened to the lecture attentively, if you have gone through the chapter thoroughly, no one can stop you to score 100 marks. These two things are required, plus map work. Map work you have to do. We have done in the class. Now it is your turn for you to do practice and to score mark. So today we'll start with the some of the questions. And first of all, I have made a map, as you people can see. So I will make certain features on the map, and you have to find out which feature I'm making. So it is this a collective effort. It means you people are supposed to name the area, whatever I'm going to pinpoint you people on a map. Be attentive. If you don't know, no problem. We will find out the answer. Woh kabhi bhi problem nahi hamare liye. But you should be attentive. Online students particularly, very much attentive. I need full-fledged attention of you people. Right? Now look at this one point I'm going to make. And this is famous as an industrial area. Industry, center is for industry. Just try to find out which area it is. And state, industry. Okay, second option is, it is agro-based industry. Map, is it clear online? Full-fledged map is clear? No, it's not Chennai. Chennai mein which industry, agro-based industry we have? Vishakhapatnam is here. So wrong. Hurry up. Fast. Right or wrong doesn't matter. Online also. At least jitna jaldi answers dete jaoge, we'll be able to draw more and more. This is agro-based industry. Which state I made? Yes. Tamil. Khayati, yes, bache?
I don't know.
Yes, ma'am. Coimbatore.
No?
I'm Coimbatore.
Very correct. That is Coimbatore. It is famous for Coimbatore. It is in Tamil famous for textile industry, cotton textile industry, Coimbatore. Very good, Khyati. Next, look at this. Very simple. State, West Bengal. State is West Bengal. If you, No. It is a backbone industry. Backbone industry, which industry?
Durgapur, iron and steel.
Iron and steel. Yes, Gujo Singh, that's correct. Kohinoor and all. Iron and steel. And which name of the center? Which center it is?
Durgapur.
Is perfect, Gujo Singh. This is Durgapur iron and steel industry. Durgapur. Perfect. Next. Very simple. I guess all of you would be able to answer me this point. And enough idea. That is? Well, enough idea. Amritsar. And it is? Perfect. Guru Ram Das International Airport. Location, say we should know about it. It is Guru Ram Das International Airport. Next. What it is? Very simple. Huh? No? You talk from your... Hard as it is okay, but you talk from your syllabus point of view.
Arid soil.
Hanji? Sandy soil. That's correct. It is sandy soil. Thar desert. Desert nahi hai because aapke syllabus mein. So it is sandy soil. Okay. Next. Okay. Here. This is hint is related to water. It is a seaport, okay? Backwater seaport, okay? Name of the seaport is Kochi seaport. Online. Is it a Kochi
seaport? Cochin.
No, ma'am. It is what then? It can be Kochi
Cochin seaport.
It can be Kochi seaport also. But seaport, Kochi seaport is extremely southwest. So Kochi seaport, halka fulka difference is okay. So that's why I said, okay, theek hai. Lekin maine kuch aur banaya hai yahan pe. Extreme southwestern seaport of India is Kochi seaport. And this
Trivandrum Software Technology Park.
Yes.
Trivandrum Software Technology Park.
Trivandrum Software Technology Park can also it can be because map is not up to scale. Yes, we can say it is. Yes. What else? Maine bola water. Okay. Maybe I have made bit to. Main thoda sa idhar banati hu shayad. Dam. Which dam? Periyar. Periyar dam. So from this we have done ek locate kiya humne and we have got three answers and almost three answers were correct. Trivandrum in Kerala, Kochi in Kerala, Periyar in Kerala. Done. Okay, next. National Park. Jim Corbett National Park. Online. Online.
Jim Corbett
National Park. Now look at this. It is like here we have Rajaji. Corbett National Park and Dudwa National Park. So three national parks are here. Annaman, Mayang. Here. That can be done later on also. Next we have, look at this. This area, okay, I'll make two or three areas. You have to guess which areas are these. Ujjain, Indore, Devas, Surat. States and famous
cotton textile.
Surat in Gujarat. And Gurjo Singh, what was your reply?
Cotton textile industry.
Perfect. Cotton textile. And cotton textile we have come to know from Surat. So that is common sense. Ki wherever we have Surat, it is cotton textile area. Otherwise, Ujjain, Devas, and Indore, these three areas are in MP and also famous for cotton. Next, we have. Okay. Okay, here. Name I am writing down. You have to tell me famous for what? It is a port, no? Yes, what else? Look at the map online. Hadri? Kahan gaya? This is no? No, mine तो है ही नहीं chapter में. Mineral and power resources not part of our syllabus.
Ma'am लिखा क्या है?
Have you learned?
Ma'am
हाँ जी, this is जपन ज्योत. Yes बच्चे.
Ma'am लिखा क्या है?
Yes, क्या बोल रहे हो? Speak up. Nuclear power plant, that's correct. Andhra Pradesh nuclear power plant, recently built power plant. This is Kudu Canal, recently built power plant, new power plant that is in Andhra Pradesh. Kudu Canal, yes. Kudu nahi, Kudu Canal. Mazak nahi banana Andhra Pradesh ke nuclear power ka, hai na? Okay. Next we have, look at this. Oldest mineral based industrial area. Oldest mineral based industrial area. Hurry up, offline.
Ma'am, Bhilai iron and steel.
Hold on, Hujo. अच्छा आपने उसके भी short form बना दी, छोटे के छोटे. Okay, Divyanshi, yes.
Divyanshi. Ma'am, Tisco.
Tisco, that is Tata Iron and Steel Company, and name of the center it is Bhilai. Bhilai Iron and Steel Plant is basically Bhilai Iron and Steel Plant. हाँ, साथ साथ ही है, जमशेदपुर में ही. हाँ, ठीक हो. City का नाम is Bhilai. Company का नाम is Tisco, Tata Iron and Steel Company, रतन टाटा के. ठीक है. Next we have. This halka sa, okay, means of transportation from this chapter, means of transportation, this area we have airways, we have waterways, we have roadways, and we have railways. So this area is famous for which means of transportation? Online, get up. All of you are sleeping mentally, I guess, excluding few. Vinayak, here.
Ma'am, Hyderabad, Rajiv Gandhi International Airport.
Perfect, Gurjot Singh. Gurjot Singh, you are totally prepared, I guess. And very good. This is Rajiv Gandhi International Airport. It's in Hyderabad. Okay, name this. Same airport.
Chennai.
Name the airport. Name the state.
Ma'am, Chennai.
Chennai. Chennai is what a state. Tamil. So if in your exam question is like
Tamil Nadu, ma'am.
Tamil, that is Meenambakkam. So if in your exam question is like this, ki locate state, you are supposed to make, write down the name of the state, that is Chennai. Sorry, Tamil. You are not supposed to write down Chennai. Chennai likhoge to wrong ho jayega aapka pura answer. Though it is in Tamil, but answer would be incorrect. So be very careful while making this. Okay. Next is a steel plant of, aise batana, a steel plant of Chhattisgarh. Any, we have very limited. A steel plant of Chhattisgarh. Online, I want answer from you also. Offline students are quite attentive. Hargunpal, I can see your beautiful picture here.
Bhilai.
Huh?
Ma'am, Bhilai steel plant.
Bhilai steel plant.
Ma'am, Bhilai.
Chhattisgarh. Okay. Next. Okay. I would like to say one thing here, bit doubtful about it. Hyderabad, in one of the books, Hyderabad International Airport, they have written the name N.T. Rama Rao International Airport. जो हमने कहा ना राजीव गांधी इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट, आई डोंट थिंक सो दे कैन डेयर टू चेंज द नेम ऑफ राजीव गांधी इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट, बट इन सम ऑफ द बुक्स आई हैव रेड रिसेंटली, मैंने कभी पढ़ा नहीं, सिर्फ एक आधी बुक में मैंने पढ़ा, दैट इज ऑल्सो प्राइवेट पब्लिशर है, नेम इज एन टी रामाराव, काइंडली कन्फर्म कर लेना, नेम चेंज तो नहीं हो गया, बिकॉज आई हैव नो आइडिया अबाउट इट, मैंने कहीं पढ़ा सुना भी नहीं है, बट बुक में है एन टी रामाराव हैदराबाद का, नेम क्लियर कर लेना. ओके
मैम, अमृतसर का भी राजा सांसी लिखा हुआ है.
ओ दैट इज रॉन्ग, वो तो वी नो इट वेरी वेल, पंजाब के हैं सरदार जी. हाँ, नेक्स्ट वी हैव, ओके लुक एट दिस, वेरी फेमस, दिस वी कॉल मींस ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन, कम्युनिकेशन यस, परफेक्ट, कोहिनूर पुणे आईटी सेंटर, दिस इज महाराष्ट्र पुणे आईटी सेंटर. ओके नेक्स्ट वी हैव, मैं वक्त तो बहुत ज्यादा, वी हैव सो, अभी भी बच्चे आ रहे हैं, सो लेट, सो आई एम प्रोसीडिंग नाउ विद द मैं वक्त, वी कैन डू टुमारो आल्सो, थोड़ा सा आज करते हैं. आई रियली वांट टू गिव अ थोरो इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट योर सैंपल पेपर रिगार्डिंग योर प्री बोर्ड एग्जाम्स या फॉर योर बोर्ड एग्जाम्स. 100% आई एम श्योर यू माइट हैव गोन थ्रू दिस, रविंदर मैम माइट हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट your sample paper, that is of history and all that. And today, first of all, I would speak the name of the chapters, which is a part of your syllabus for board, for pre-board exams. Though we have done, we have moved accordingly, but even then I have to, there's a need to repeat it because, okay, don't ask later me, ma'am, kindly send it through WhatsApp, personally, ma'am, syllabus, ma'am, maps, please. We do everything in the class thoroughly, okay? So I'm going to repeat the syllabus. First, geography, resources, full-fledged chapter. Second chapter is water resources. Nothing from water resources excluding map. Except map, nothing from water resources. Map wala portion hi hai sirf, usme bhi, map mein what? Different dams in the country. It means only one prominent map, that is dams in the country. Rivers, dams, if you will locate dam, to automatically you have to locate river. So, wo dono hi hai. Dam aise locate nahi karoge, you have to make river. Okay? Next is agriculture, types of agriculture, cropping pattern, all we have done, technological, institutional, impact of globalization. So, full-fledged map. In chapter agriculture, next is chapter, yes. Nahi. It's not mentioned here. Next, we have minerals, full-fledged maps of minerals. Nothing theoretical, no theory from mineral and power resource, only and only maps. Done. Next, we have manufacturing industries. All industries, I told you beforehand, before also, again, I'm telling you, all industries you are supposed to do. Like some of the industries, we don't consider it as a prominent industry like in your NCRT, it is mentioned fertilizer industry, cement industry, all industries you have supposed to do. We, while discussing the chapter, we have already covered the syllabus. But some of the industries, though it is not in your syllabus, but generally can be asked. So I never say don't do. Always do all the industry because areas, nothing extraordinary you have to learn. Wahi areas hain jo aap main industries mein karoge. So map is very important of industry and theoretical portion, but the full-fledged chapter. Next we have lifelines of Indian economy, full-fledged chapter along with map, that is of railway, roadway, and of airways, waterways. Done. Next we have chapter, economics. We have four chapters, development, sectors of Indian economy, money and credit, and globalization, and the Indian economy. Now, if I talk about the maps, I can dictate maps also, but I don't want to waste time. If you remember, already we have, I have sent you proper list of maps. Again, I will do, not a big deal if you need, but otherwise all maps you are supposed to do. I'm going to start with the questions. Get ready. One more question. First of all, I'm going to ask online, offline, as well as every one of you. Thoroughly, your attention should be with me. Nothing here and there. Forget about your surroundings. So, first question is, how is GDP calculated? Any one of you? One mark here, though it is, but bit detail. How is GDP calculated? Any one of you? I don't want perfect definition if it is not in your mind right now, but whatever you understand from that, speak up. Online. Yes? Production of all three sectors. Okay. Only production of all three sectors. Thought is a mistake. Mistake, maybe you can't say mistake. Something is missing here. Okay. Yes. How is GDP calculated? Rough idea. Online. So many are here. Yes, Pragati, beta. Speak up.
Ma'am, it is the sum of production of all the three sectors in the terms of money.
Pragati, speak louder. अपने नेबर तक अपनी आवाज पहुंचाओ. Speak louder.
Ma'am, it is the sum of all the three sectors in terms of money.
It is a sum total of all the three sectors in
ma'am, production, the sum of production of all three sectors.
Sum of production of all three sectors, that's correct. It is a sum total of final goods produced by us, final goods as well as the services, both the things. In this, we don't talk only about goods. Well, like right now, I'm not producing any good to you. I'm giving my service, but I'm involved in economical sector. In the same way, doctors, they are giving their services to us. So final total, sum total of all the goods, final goods, plus the services produced by all three sectors, primary, secondary, and tertiary, that is known as GDP. Okay. Next is, how is public sector different from private sector? Any one of you? How is public sector different from primary private sector? Very simple. Yes, under government, and that is under private hands. So public sector is run by government and private sector is run by individual or group of individual. Next question is, Dash industry, okay, this is fill up. Manpreet, be attentive. Dash industry is the basic industry since all the other industries, heavy, medium, and light, depend on it for machinery. Perfect. That is iron and steel industry. Perfect. In which of the following state is Kaiga nuclear energy power located? Kaiga. I won't give you any option. Kaiga. Yeah, Kaiga, jisko aap bolte ho. Nuclear power station. Where is it? No. Andhra, maybe you have Kudu Canal. Madhya Pradesh, there is not even a single. Uttar Pradesh, we have Naroda. Rajasthan, we have Rawat Bhatta. Huh?
Gujarat.
Let online students also come forward. Yes,
ma'am,
yes.
Karnataka.
Karnataka, that's correct. It is in Karnataka. Kaiga, it is approximately here. Here we have Karnataka, and approximately here we have Kaiga nuclear power plant. It should be on your tips. I repeat, Naroda, it is in UP. Rawat Bhatta, Rajasthan. Tarapur, Maharashtra. Kakrapara, Gujarat. Kaiga, Karnataka. Kalpakkam, Tamil. And Kudu Canal, Andhra. Haan. Book mein mein likha, we have done the maps also. We have done it also. It was in your question PT2 also. अभी आई गेस अभी जागे हो आप, है ना? हाँ हाँ, लिखे हुए हैं, एवरीथिंग इज इन ए बुक, ठीक है, डोंट वरी. नेक्स्ट इज ऑनलाइन, आज आप लोग काफी सुस्त लग रहे हैं बच्चे. डैश इंडस्ट्री इज यूज्ड फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एयरक्राफ्ट यूटेंसिल एंड वायर्स. Bash industry is used for making aircraft, utensils and wires. Aluminium. Perfect. This is aluminium smelting industry. We don't have much centers in India. A maximum aluminium smelting areas, that is in Odisha. Maximum are here. Nalco, Balco, yes, prominent centers and companies here. Next question is, which is the oldest artificial seaport of India? Oldest artificial seaport of India? Bombay is natural. Okay, clue. It is on the eastern side of India. Online, get up. Huh? It is in the eastern side of India. It's a clue.
Kolkata?
That is Chennai, that's correct.
Chennai port.
Okay, next we have, which is the deepest landlocked and well-protected seaport of India and while perfect. Vishakhapatnam, very famous from naval point of view also. So such type of questions can be asked, though there are some economical questions also we have done, but certain questions we can't speak in the class because that are that other kind. Okay, I'm going to ask 3 mark questions now. Tertiary sector, yes, Japan, ask it out. Japan Jo.
Ma'am, ek bar oldest artificial seaport bata do.
Oldest artificial seaport is Chennai, Tamil. Chennai in Tamil. Okay, done, Japan?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, 3 mark question. Listen to the question. If you think question is out of your reach, you can tell me. Otherwise, I'll proceed with the next question. Tertiary sector activities help in the development of primary and secondary sector. Or option with this question it is, primary sector was the most important sector of economic activity at initial stages of development. Can you attempt the question? Primary sector was the most important sector of economic activity at initial stages of development. Matlab jab development, because us time we were not having any industry, we were not having bank and all that, we were having just primary sector, that is agriculture, mining, fishing, farming, forestry. Next question is, importance of judicious use of resources, and option is with this, different steps of resource planning. This was in the first PPT one. So three step inventory, wala, mapping, surveying, if you remember, right? Skill, technology, action. Yes. Option here? Huh? Or choice is there. Internal choice. This pattern says, otherwise, internal choices are there. But we can't depend on that. We have done all the syllabus. So, and agar if you have to choose in the board exams or pre-board exam, if you have to choose, be very careful. We people never give you choices. Na, hame nurses aap logo ko bhi choice nahi milti hai. So when you people appear in the exam, you get confused ki kaun sa question kare. Hamesha wo question karna hai jiske points bahut zyada bane, puri aapki mastery ho, aur agar map ban jaye, if it is from geography, if it is from economics, if examples you have, soch ke attempt karna hai. Choice question mein kya hota hai, bacche fas jate hain, unko lagta hai ye sahi aata hai, patapat likh do, choose nahi karna aata. So be very careful while choosing a question, which question you have to attempt. You should have enough mastery over the question. If geography map is here, if economics examples are there, then attempt the question. Okay, okay, next question is, banks play an important role in the economic development of the country. Support the statement. Next is, isme just write down the main point. I really like the answer. Write down the main point. Main points. First is provide loan. Banks provide loan to us. Second is accept deposits. Third is act as a mediator. Fourth is helps in development. And last is provide credit loan. हाँ जी, इंक्रीज इन अमाउंट, Interest rate. Okay, next question I'm proceeding. Map question that is here. Just going to ask the maps if you think you don't. Okay, otherwise we'll do it on the blackboard. First we have Sardar Sarovar Dam. Narmada. Location is approximately here. Gujarat. Sardar Sarovar Dam. Location is approximately here. These questions which we are discussing right now, it is from CBSE sample paper. Issue to schools. Okay. Next we have Bhilai Iron and Steel Plant, already we have done. Pune Software Technology Park, already we have done. Kochi Major Seaport, luckily already we have done. Indore also we have done. Naroda is left. Luckily we have done all. Good. Here we have Naroda Iron and Steel. Nuclear Power Plant. Done. Okay. So one sample paper we have discussed. Moving to the second one. Listen to the question. BPO, business processes outsourcing, BPO, is an example of dash industry in India. Business process outsourcing, BPO. Have you heard about call centers? A part of that. BPO is business process outsourcing. Maybe multinational companies, they get the work done from some other countries. And business process outsourcing. So BPO, Vinayak, are you okay? Are you listening? Okay. So that is an example of which industry? I've given you the clue also side by side. IT industry. Okay. Next question is, green revolution has helped dash industry to expand in different parts of India. Agro-based industry, that's correct. Next we have, and green revolution has helped fertilizer industry would be appropriate answer. Okay. Next question is, barley is a rabi crop, cotton is a kharif crop, dash is a zayad crop. A dash is a zayad crop. The options are wheat, mustard, soybean, cucumber. You have done it. Cucumber. Watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, they all are part of Zayad season. Zayad season means extreme summer season. And extreme summer season in India is in the months of May and June. And we people generally consume watermelon, muskmelon, and cucumber in this particular May and June. Okay? Next question is, which one of the following options describe collateral? Collateral, remember collateral? Okay. Options are double coincidence of wants, certain products for barter, trade in barter, asset as guarantee for loan. Perfect. Assets as guarantee.
D option.
Yes, Japan? Japan, you want to say something?
Okay,
I don't know what you have spoken. Chalo. Next is, read the given statement in context of globalization and choose the correct option. Options are, I repeat, globalization is related, choose the correct option. It is the only way for economic development of the country. Interlinks only production-based activities in dispersed locations in the world. It has always given only positive results in all the countries. It leads to spread of technology, culture, and diseases from a region to another. Which option is correct? Fourth option is perfectly correct. Okay, next question is 3-mark question. Suggest and explain any three ways to protect land from degradation in various states of India. Kar loge aram se question? Okay. In the same way, question can also be asked like reasons for the land degradation in India, right? Next we have, okay, very simple question and good question. Imagine yourself to be XYZ, a member of women's self-help group. Analyze the ways through which your group provide loan to the member. In this question, what you will write down in detail about SHG, self-help group. And उसमें SHG group का मतलब ही क्या है? They pool the resources, like 6-7 students are here. You pool your resources. Say every month you are able to, extremely poor people are, you are able to save just say rupees 100 or 500. So every year 500 rupees आप pool करते हो. And whosoever is in need at the end of the month or next month, say after collecting 50,000 that is with you, 5,000 rupees are with you. So after collection, whosoever member of the group is in need of money, you will hand over that 5,000 to that person and it will act as a loan. Is this point clear? So SHG, remember self-help group we have done in thoroughly in the economics. So next is the issue of sustainability is important for development. कर लोगे importance of sustainable development. This is basically from the first chapter of resources. So tomorrow again we'll do the same revision. So kind